of corruption is nothing less than staggering. We have seen the core leadership of the rebels, admittedly being al-Qaeda, that has killed U.S. troops. The L.A. Times, Reuters, others have admitted it. It's now admitted that for 6 months, notice Obama said that he could launch the war with U.N. approval, doesn't need any stinking Congress. Badges? We don't need no stinking badges. Congress? We don't need no stinking Congress. That they launched that attack 6 months ago. That was in Reuters this morning. That 6 months ago, the West began aiding rebels. The rebels hadn't even attacked yet 6 months ago. They trained them. It turns out NATO a year ago did drills of bombing different cities. The West went in, funded violent terrorist al-Qaeda groups to attack Libya and to take the country. And they've shipped arms into them from the beginning, from before the start of conflict. And now it is admitted in Reuters. I was reading today, and there it was in Reuters. It said the six-month campaign and that they'd been aiding them from the beginning. For months and months, they denied this, even though it leaked out in the foreign press. I mean, they just lie and lie and lie. And then these rebel commanders are in the news shooting their mouths off about, yes, I have killed Americans in Iraq, and I will kill more again. But first, I will kill Qaddafi. What? I mean, I'm living in the twilight zone here. And so Qaddafi, 42 years in power, is now saying that he's going to fight on till the end. He will either die as a martyr or be victorious against the dogs and devils, to quote him, that have taken over, quote, his country. And the issue is he was clearly a benevolent dictator. I don't like dictators. I don't like centralized systems. But every once in a while you get a guy who wants to build up the country and build up the continent. And most of the money actually was spent on the people. And the bureaucracy was very, very small. And the women got tuition to go to college. And everybody got thousands of dollars of stipend every year. And automobiles and houses and apartment buildings built everywhere. And the globalists looked at that and they said, this ain't happening. Especially when Qaddafi went to the rest of Africa and said, let's make our own currency. Let's create our own credit-backed currency. Really the American system. And the bankers said, uh-uh. And Qaddafi even tried to invest with the globalists. He tried to make deals with them 7 years ago. And they went in and hired al-Qaeda to attack, called them rebels, called them protesters, and have now taken Tripoli. And Qaddafi's hiding in his underground labyrinth that he's built in 40-plus years of knowing that this time was coming. And the civil war is now beginning. And he's called on the different tribes that are loyal to him to fight incessantly. And if you study the fascists when they went into Libya, out of Italy, under the leader of Italy at the time, the dictator Benito Mussolini, El Duce, or whatever you call him, they fought him for a decade. And if you look at the monarch the British installed, constant fighting. So you were told this was being done for humanitarian reasons. That country is now going to descend back into the sand from which it came. And good old boys seem to think that they get ahead by going, glass parking lot them. Glass parking lot them. They're just people like us that want a future. And this does not send a very good message to the world that Qaddafi tried to, quote, work with the West and got double-crossed. And now they're going to put Sharia law in. That was reported yesterday. So the women that thought they were going to run around and drive cars and be doctors, you are going home and you're going to put a bag over your head. And that's the end of that. And that's victory because they do not want, the establishment does not want the Middle East and North Africa or any other country for that matter or region to rise up, to build itself up. And they do not want countries that are upwardly mobile. And so they have been bombed into the Stone Age, and they will be kept there. And the more people get killed, the better for the globalist. They could care less about U.S. troops or mercenaries that die, and they sure could care less about the Libyan people. And so this is a huge humanitarian bloodbath in the name of peace by our peace laureate. Qaddafi has fled Tripoli headquarters, ransacked by rebels. That is confirmed that they've taken over one of his bases and are now in tunnel battles all under the country trying to find out where Qaddafi is. And Qaddafi is, you can say whatever you want about him, he is a fighter. He knows that when they kill him, he's going to be a martyr. So they're going to try to not kill him. But Qaddafi is probably going to go out shooting. They've put a big price on his head, too, trying to get his inner circle to turn against him. So very disgusting what's going on there. In some of the other news, it's been confirmed that the Green Square video that you were shown 3 days ago, the rebels occupying it, was fake and was shot in another country. But it worked. The Libyans saw that and thought, oh, the city's been taken. And the special forces that were inserted, creating havoc, were able to create enough fear to get Qaddafi's forces to basically run around a wild goose chase looking for him long enough for the rebels to converge and start destroying government buildings and basically panic and rout Qaddafi's forces. So they just kept trying the same psyop over and over again until it worked. Now, here's the big issue of the day, and I really should have opened the show with this. I think I mentioned it, but I should probably shoot a special report on this alone, because this is the threat I've seen from the beginning. They corner Qaddafi. He could really activate some previously paid off sleeper cells, similar to the sleeper cells that attacked in Tripoli and linked up with the flotilla that came in the night with the Arab al-Qaeda fighters backed by British SAS, French commandos, U.S. commandos. They could activate real sleeper cells in the West, blow some stuff up, which is basically giving the globalist, if Qaddafi does that, a big present. Which makes me think that's why Qaddafi hasn't launched nerve gas or hasn't attacked Europe, as he threatened to do, because then that will only legitimize some of this. So they'll probably do it. I guarantee you, they're looking at staging stuff. I don't know if they're going to pull the trigger and blaming it on Qaddafi to then legitimize it. Well, see, he's a terrorist. He blew up a school bus. If Qaddafi was really going to do things, he'd have sleeper cells to target politicians here. You know, sleeper cells that would wait, say, a year, or go after certain bankers or certain oil company heads. But the truth is, most of these countries don't really have terror forces. They don't have special forces. They don't have sleeper cells. That's America that has that, because we're not America. We're run by the bankers. And they have sleeper cells, blow stuff up, and blame it on whoever they want to invade next. So the truth is, you never know who's really staging these things. You sure know who's got scripts out in minutes, though, to capitalize on these events, don't you? Yep, our whore media. Nuclear expert warns of Libya dirty bomb. Ooh, dirty bomb. They're going to get you. A research center near Tripoli has stocks of nuclear material that could be used to make a dirty bomb, a former senior UN inspector said on Wednesday, warning of possible looting during turmoil in Libya. Oh, yeah, that's the other narrative. Al-Qaeda, that's the good Al-Qaeda. There's bad Al-Qaeda, and our media says then there's loving good Al-Qaeda. Now, loving good Al-Qaeda is real Al-Qaeda that's actually killed U.S. soldiers in Iraq. Then there's the bad fairy tale Al-Qaeda that supposedly carries out the terror attacks. But they're saying that the bad Al-Qaeda might get the fissile material that a CIA officer was caught 4 months ago trying to give to the Pakistani Al-Qaeda. But the ISA stopped them before they could do that frame up. And so now they're saying that somebody could get it and dirty bomb us. And then they'll tell us that it came from Libya and Muammar Gaddafi and al-Qaeda, because he works with al-Qaeda, don't you know? He was the guy to first put out an Interpol arrest warrant for him in 96. And then they tried to have al-Qaeda assassinate him. That's all confirmed. But see, he's al-Qaeda. That's why al-Qaeda just took over the country, because they're fighting who they work for, Muammar Gaddafi, because the television said so. Seeking to mend ties with the West, Libyans, Muammar Gaddafi agreed in 2003 to abandon efforts to acquire nuclear, chemical, and biological weapons, a move that brought him in from the cold and helped end decades of Libyan isolation. And the setup... You know, Qaddafi really sold out to the globalists. Before, he kept most of the wealth and gave it to the population and kept some for himself. In the last 8 years, he did start giving it to the bankers. And you see how they repaid him. Just like they're going to repay all you U.S. military people by taking your pension funds. Same thing for you mercenaries. But hey. So they're now saying, al-Qaeda, Libya, you're going to get us. But we're like, but al-Qaeda... is the group you brought in. Well, still. Ask yourselves, what are you doing in this time of great challenge? What are you doing to unlock minds?